So when I see Toulouse, I remember it's the hometown of Fermat. So our last speaker, Professor Yun Xun Ge, is from Université de Toulouse, and he will talk about regularity of optimal transport on compact nearly spherical manifolds. Let's welcome.
Thanks. First, I would like to thank the organizer for the invitation. Today, I will talk about some regularity issue for the optimal transport map on the manifold. So, we will present the problem. So, we consider n-dimensional Riemannian manifold. Here, we consider the compact case. So we consider two probability measure with the density rho zero and rho one. So we count, we denote S mu zero mu one a set of all Borel maps S push forward the measure mu zero to the mu one. This means that if we take any subset on the manifold M, so the measure for the set B on the measure mu one is equal to the measure of pre-image of the B on the map S. So here we consider a special cost function on the manifold. Is just the Riemannian distance square divided by two. So the classical Monge problem is to try to find a map in the in the site S mu zero mu one which can minimize the total cost function. The total cost function is defined just as the cost function from P to the phi of P. Phi is the map in this site, push forward mu zero to mu one. So we integral this one. So before the, well, there is a, here we consider the special case is just we suppose that the measure is supported on the whole manifold. So before the present, the existing result, I will talk about the C-convex function. C-convex function on the manifold M is just we can find another function on M such that for any point on the manifold, omega x is equal to the slope of minus c x y minus alpha y. So this C-convex function is a natural generalization of convex function. So for example, we see for the Euclidean metric, so in this case, the cost function is just one half x minus y, the Euclidean norm square. So this one we can write as one half the norm of x plus one half norm of y square minus the product between x and y. So in such case, the slope for y, the Euclidean space minus c xy minus alpha y. This one we can write as the supreme for the y, minus 1/2 square of a, the norm of x plus the product between x x and y minus y of alpha y plus 1/2 y square. So we can get out this term is just 1/2 the normal x square plus the sup for y on the rn, the product between the x and y minus this function. So this function is this transformation is just classical Legendre transformation. So so this function is convex. So that means for the if we consider the function plus 1/2 the normal square is just the convex function for the w. So a special case of result due to the Brainier on the Euclidean space, and later on by Marquin and Manifolds, told us we can find a unique minimizer in the set push forward mu 0 to mu 1. Moreover, for these optimal transport maps, we can find a C convex function U such that the G of X is just the exponential of gradient U of the at point X. So that means we can write this G from M to M as an exponential map of some of its potential function U. So here we consider the regularity problem. It's just we want to know if the density is regular and away from the zero. We want to know the potential function is regular or not. So for this regularity problem, we can find a PDE setting. So if we suppose the potential function is C2, so these potential functions satisfy fully nonlinear PDE of Monge-Ampere type. It's just a determinant of this matrix equal to second member. This matrix is given by the Hessian of cost C for the first variable and plus the Hessian of potential function. So the second member is just involve just the first derivative of U. So it's a classical Monge-Ampere type equation. So for the C1 regularity, so that means C1 for the potential or continuity for the optimal transport maps, there are many works by Figali, Hefor, Marquin, and Kim, and later on by New and Vidoir. So here we interest in the higher order regularity. So the first result in this for this problem is proved by Cavarelli in 1902. He proved the result in the Euclidean space. In 1909, Gordero he proved the result for the flat tourists. In 2011, Loebert proved the regularity result on the sphere for the complex, some special or homogeneous manifold, complex or quaternion project space is proved by Kim McCann and later on by Figali Kim McCann. So we know that for the product space, the regularity result is also proved by Figali Kim McCann. Here I talk the regularity result is just we have for any regularity measure. We want to know that unique optimal transport map is also continuous, is also regular. So later on, Loebert and Verny and Danu and myself proved the regularity result for the manifold close to the sphere in some norm. So and the top log of the manifold is non-trivial. So Denanoy in 2015, he proved that for two-dimensional surface simply connected, if the scalar curvature is close to one in C2 norm, then we can prove the optimal transport map is regular. So I will so we know that we are interesting also that in which case on which manifold the optimal transport map is not regular. So the first example is given by Loebert. So he proved that if the manifold have some negative section curvatures, in such case we can find two regular measures such that the unique optimal transport map is not continue. So later on, Kim prove that, for example, for some convex surface in 2D. So in this case, the section curvature is positive everywhere, but we can find the regular measure such that the optimal transport map is not regular. So later on, Loebert and Venani proved that even for the revolution surface, some ellipse evolution of ellipse. So if the ratio of two x is large enough, so I mean that for the revolution ellipse. If this ratio is large enough, so we can also find the regular measure such that the unique transport optimal transport map is not regular. So we want to present some geometric picture of this regularity problem. So we consider the C curvature or Ma-Chutin Wang curvature introduced by Ma-Chutin Wang. So on the manifold, we consider on the vector field vector in the non-tangent in the catalogue is not in the catalogue. So we take manifold, we take a vector dungeon and point M0. So M0 V0 is in the not cut locus. This means that geodesic exponential M0 T V0 for the T between 0 and 1 is minimizing geodesic. In such case, we define the C curvature just like the minus second derivative with respect to the Dungeon vector of this function A in the direction nu and nu. Here, nu and xi so, are also two Dungeon vector and point M0. So we have three Dungeon vector, xi and nu. So so this function A is given just we make the Hessian of cost function for the first variable, and we take the same direction xi and xi. So for example, on the standard fields, the function A is just given by this function, this function. So it's just the normal of the Dungeon vector of c square minus one minus the normal of Dungeon vector v times cotangent of normal of v times the normal of c square minus the product between the c and the v square over the normal of v square. So this Mach shooting one tensor we can see as some cross curvature of some pseudo Riemannian metric. For this intrinsic interpretation is found by Kim and McCann. So and on the manifold M times M, we consider the pseudo Riemannian metric is given by the second derivative of cost function is given by zero. This is zero, is minus one half, and here is derivative with respect to x, with respect to y, say x, y. Is here is a derivative with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to x, say xy. So for this matrix of 2m times 2n, so the signature is just n and n. That means it's a pseudo Riemannian metric. So the C curvature we define before is just the Riemannian curvature for this matrix and the plane spanned by the vector C0 A and 0 nu. This is a two Dungeon vector on the product space. So we want to introduce the different curvature condition. So the first one is just we take Dungeon vector M0V in non-cut locus, and we take two Dungeon vector on the spheric bundle, and this is two Dungeon vector and point M0. We suppose these two Dungeon vector are orthogonal. So we call the condition A3 weak. It's just the C curvature. This guy is non-negative. I call condition A3 strong is just this C curvature is positive. So another type of condition on the curvature is just here. We don't suppose that the two unit tangent vector are orthogonal. We call the non-negative C curve is just this C curvature is non-negative and almost positive C curvature. This means non-negative C curve plus the condition. The C curvature vanish if and only if these three vector V0, C nu at point M0 are in the same line. So the relation between the regularity problem and this curvature condition is the following. So if we assume the suitable condition and on the domain of on the manifold, we can see that the regularity problem is equivalent to a curvature condition A3 weak. So the study the regularity problem now is became a curvature problem. So the first difficult to prove the regularity is about this curvature condition, A3 weak or A3 strong. For the closed manifold, there is another difficult is that how to avoid the cut locus. So for this difficult come from the equation. We can see for the PDE setting for this Munch unpacked type the equation. So for example, if we consider if the vector is close to conjugate locus, this quantity, the determinant of expansion, differential of expansion map is close to zero. This is the reason for which that from the PDE point of view, that this guy will go to the infinity. So this lead to the equation became degenerate. So what's the relation between this C curvature and the section curvature and the manifold? So Noaper proved in the 2009 that on the diagonal, the C curvature is nothing than the section curvature. So a natural direct consequence is that if the condition A3 weak satisfy, automatically the section curvature should be non-negative. So this is the reason for which the Noaper could prove that if the section curvature is negative somewhere, we can find the optimal transform map which is not regular. So natural question is that if the section curvature is non-negative, we want to know if the C curvature is positive or not. So the answer is still no. The counter example is that the first constraint by Kim. He proves that even for the some convex surface, we can find we can prove that the C curvature is negative somewhere. This is the reason for which we know that even on the surface, or even for the surface with positive section curvature, it's possible that the C curvature is negative. We have also some positive answer. So Lepere in 2011, he proved that the A3 strong condition is satisfied on the standard field. And Kim Markham proved that A3 weak hold on the Riemannian subdimension of the round sphere, and also for the product of a standard sphere. So a natural question is to try to understand how the C curvature can be controlled by the Riemannian curvature. So natural answer is that a C2 norm of a Riemannian curvature controls C0 norm of C curvature. This is quite natural because we see that the C curvature is defined by this metric. This metric involves the second derivative of cost function. So the curvature of this metric will involve the fourth order derivative of a distant function. So in some words, we can think it's about the fourth order derivative of a metric. So the remaining metric is just second order derivative of metric. So there's a two order derivative difference. So we know that on the standard field, the A3 strong condition hold. So we want to know if the stability result is hold or not. So this is proved by Figali-Hefer, Venani, and Denano and myself. We prove that if the metric on the manifold is close to the metric to the sphere in C4 norm, or the curvature is close in C2 norm, and the top loss of the manifold is non-trivial. In this case, A3 strong condition still hold. So later on with the Delannoy, we prove that on the surface, if the simply connected surface, if the Gauss curvature is close to the constant one in the C2 norm, so this strong condition almost positive C curvature hold. I want to state the main results. So we will note the Riemannian curvature by Riem, and given three vector fields on the manifold, we define three one tensor. Curve one is just the product between the W and the V times vector U minus product between W and U times V. Well, we not case section curvature. So our first result with Jian Ye is about the stability result. We suppose that we can find a constant data independent of manifold, which depend on any on the dimension. If the n dimension manifold simply connected satisfy the minimum of section curvature equal to 1, and the Riemannian curvature minus Q1 in C2 norm is smaller than delta, so the condition APCC hold. So moreover, we have more precise estimate. It's just the C curvature can be bounded from below by some constant times this quantity. This quantity is just we take the three Dungeon vector and point M0, V, C, nu. So we take the parallelogram for this three vector. So this quantity is just the arrow of the boundary of this body. So to prove this result, we know that on the sphere, APCC hold, and there is several parts. So we will analyze the along the diagonal. So we use the asymptotic analysis for the Jacobian fields. And another difficult point is about cut locus. We use result found by Venani, Kim, Figali, Hifov, and Venani. So they found a special expression for the C curvature expansion. There are 15 terms they can put in some square. The square of some combination, so it's really lack analysis. It's quite difficult for this compilation. So after that, between the diagonal and the cut locus, it's just we use the perturbation argument. So once we prove the stability result, we can prove directly on the product space the non-negative C curve hold if each copy is close to the sphere in the C2 norm. So I will explain to this curvature condition. So for the standard sphere, we know that the Riemannian curvature is just Q1. So Q1, if we write in product, Q1 is just, if we write as the 4-0 tensor, Q1 is just a metric product with metric. So if this quantity equal to 0, it just means that section curvature equal to 1 everywhere. So once we prove the curvature condition, we try to prove the regularity issue. So as I mentioned, that we have the difficulty is about avoid a cut locus. So our result is if we give two regular density mu zero, rho zero and rho one, and these two guys is away from zero, so we can find epsilon, which depends on the rho zero and rho one, such that for any point on the manifold, the distance between the image on the optimal transform map of x and its distance with cut locus of point x is bounded from below. To prove this result, we use a maximum principle for the Funi nonlinear PDE. So I will try to give some idea of this proof. So to prove this result, we need to choose the test function. So the test function is constructed in the following ways. So we not J0 is a matrix. It's just a matrix Jacobian fields. J1 is also. So along the geodesic, non-minimizing geodesic exponential M0 TV for T between 0 and 1. For J1 at time 0 is equal to 0, and his derivative at 0 is equal to your identity. So for the zero, J0 is just at the point 0 is identity for the is derivative at 0 is equal to 0. So for the on the standard sphere, so this G1 is just given by T and 0, 0. Here is just sine TV, the number of V, time over time of V times identity of order M minus 1. And for the J0 on the Stanfield sphere is just here is just 1, here is cosine T, the normal of vector V times identity M minus 1. So we construct the test function on the Dungeon bundle. Here X is the point and the M, C is the Dungeon vector, is given by this formula. So we suppose that this test function attains the minimum and the subset of sphere bundle, and also the Dungeon vector is orthogonal to the gradient of U at point X. We suppose this minimum is attained and positive. So we can use the information about the critical condition for this point, and also we use the equation satisfied by the optimal transport maps. And also, as this is a minimum of the test function, so we have also the second derivative condition. On make all these conditions together, we can prove the optimal transport is away from the cut locus. So once we prove the away cut locus, so we try to find the high order a priori estimate. This is because the still because the maximal principle due to the matrix one. So this geometric condition on the curvature is three strong will help us to get the CTO estimate for the solution. So once we have a CTO estimate, so this equation is uniform elliptic equation, so we can use the standard elliptic PDE due to the Evans or Kinoff-Safanoff. We have C2 solution, we have C2 alpha estimate. So after that, once we have the this a pretty estimate, we use the continuous method to prove the result. So we have two major mu 0 and mu 1, which are regular on the manifold. So mu 0, mu 1. So we can collect it, these two measures by a loop for T between 0 1, we not mu mu T is just 1 minus T mu 0 plus T times mu 1. So we consider optimal transport map push forward mu T to push forward the mu 0 to the mu T. Optimal transport map push
mu 0 to mu t. So we will not, A is set for the t between the 0, 1, such that the gt is regular. So we know that for t equal to 0, so this optimal transport map is just push forward mu 0 to the mu 0. So identity is the unique optimal transport map. So in this case, this map is regular. So because we have the a priori estimate, we can prove this set is closed. And also, because we have regular in this, this one is mu t, so is C1 alpha is just the potential is C2 alpha. So for the C2 alpha, we can linearize the operator because this is elliptic, uniform elliptic, so we can prove this set is also open by open by the because the differential of this map is isomorphism, so we can give the result that A is open and closed and no is not empty. So we prove that for the t equal to 1, this optimal transport map is also regular. So I finish my talk. Thank you very much. This one or this just gave the precise gave the estimate from below. If we have the C2 norm of the curvature and the Riemannian manifold, so the C curvature can be bounded from below by some constant, positive constant, times this quantity. This quantity by Cauchy-Schwarz inequality is always positive. And this one equal to 0 if and only if 3 Dungeon vector and the point M are in the same line. Yes, but this condition is more strong because these two Dungeon vector is not necessarily orthogonal. So if it's orthogonal, this guy is equal to 0, but this one is equal to 1. So this is strictly positive.
Are there other questions? Okay, thank you for spending a long day here. Let's thank Professor Ge again.